Welcome to the Academy, a series focused on the basics of Star Wars: The Old Republic.
Karagga's Palace is the second operation added to Star Wars: The Old Republic, and is one of the two shorter introductory operations that are great first choices for players new to playing operations. While this operation is considered quite easy, and you'll probably be fine to jump right in without a guide, this video will go over all the details of this operation so you can know exactly what you're getting into. The Heavy Fabricator Droid is the fourth boss in Karagga's Palace, but this boss is more often known as the Puzzle Boss, as there is a puzzle you can solve to damage the boss by diverting power to the pipes hanging overhead. Originally, when this operation was released, your team would need to solve the puzzle in every difficulty mode. But to make operations easier for new players to progress through, the puzzle is auto-solved for your team in story mode. All you'll need to do is activate the puzzle by right-clicking the blue button on the upper level, which will turn on all the screens of the puzzle green, letting you know that the puzzle has been successfully solved and you can fire on the boss when ready. The puzzle was originally designed with the concept that the droid would move between three different pipes, with each pipe blasting the boss with a different type of attack. But that strategy was never actually used by players, and instead, most teams just keep him on the right-hand side pipe where he starts off. In story mode, you can assign one of your healing or long-range teammates to be upstairs to fire the pipe, while the rest of your team stays downstairs. The player staying upstairs will fire the pipe anytime it becomes available again. To fire the pipe, right-click the glowing blue button under the most right-hand side of the screens. The pipe can be fired about every 45 seconds, and when the pipe is ready, the button will glow blue. Red text will appear on the screen saying System Reset Complete, Fire Sequence Available, and the upstairs player can heal or damage the boss from the top platform between button presses. Most teams will bring the boss to the far right pipe of the puzzle on the lower floor and keep him there, blasting the boss with the fire pipe. The easiest way for the tank to keep him in place is by putting their back against the factory door on the far right, the kind of conveyor belt door. They won't need to move for the rest of the fight once there. The tank that is holding the boss will receive a stacking debuff called Battered, which reduces their armor for every stack. The more stacks the tank has, the more damage the tank will take. Your team can choose to outheal it, or have two tanks swap back and forth with the boss as the debuff wears off, which takes roughly 30 seconds after the tank stops being attacked by the boss. If you get a yellow-orange targeting circle on you, run away from your teammates as you're about to explode with a sticky bomb and will hit any of your nearby team members. This hits surprisingly hard, even in story mode. It actually hurts way more than getting hit by the fire from the pipe, and it hits anyone nearby when it explodes. In veteran mode, the puzzle does actually need to be solved. The blue button instead turns on the red and green screens hanging from the ceiling and actually activates the puzzle. The puzzle is known as the Tower of Hanoi, a very old logic puzzle. The goal of the traditional puzzle is to create a tower in one of the three columns, with the largest piece on the bottom, the medium piece in the middle, and the smallest piece on top. You can only pick up one piece at a time, and you can't place a larger piece on top of a smaller one in a column. The puzzle starts off with no pieces picked up, which is represented by the very top middle screen being red, and a green piece of the puzzle in each of the columns, with the smallest piece on the left and biggest on the right. To pick up a piece, you click the large blue button in front of the column you want to pick up the topmost piece from, which will move the piece to be picked up position in the middle of the screen that's separated from the others. You can then click a different column's blue button, which will place the picked up piece on top of that pile if it can fit there. The general idea of solving the Tower of Hanoi puzzle is that you start by picking up the middlemost piece, place it on top of the biggest piece, then pick up the smallest piece and place it on top of that stack, completing the puzzle. Once the tower is created, with three green screens stacked up in the same column, a second thin blue button will light up below the column. This is how you damage the boss. Clicking that second thinner blue button will blast the boss, and anyone else within range, from the pipe on the ceiling. To solve the puzzle the first time, you bring the middle piece up, put it on the right stack, then bring the little lonely piece on the left, bring it up, and put it on the top of the right stack, which solves the puzzle for the first firing. After that, you need to solve the puzzle with the entire stacked tower starting on the right, making it slightly harder, and you will need to unstack it by making a tiny stack of two, then remove the bottom piece from the original stack, put it back, then start again. experienced players will have actually kind of memorized the fastest pattern and can flip through it super fast. So it actually goes right, left, right, middle, left, middle, right, left, right, middle, left, middle, right, left, right, fire! I'm not going to be able to remember that, but I do understand how to solve the puzzle, which helps me solve it at least at a slow rate. Also in veteran mode, throughout the fight, if you're not fast enough at firing the pipe or solving the puzzle, two types of droids will appear. The most important one to pay attention for is the stun droid, as it will stun nearby members of your team, so you'll want to kill them or push them away if they appear. You'll especially want to protect your tank, otherwise you can ignore the droids and focus on the boss. In veteran mode, groups will often split up their team with some ranged players and a healer up top on the platforms helping press the buttons, and melee down below with the boss. If you assign a player to each console, so 3 team members upstairs and 5 downstairs, your upstairs teammates should be able to solve the puzzle fast enough so you never even see any droids. Otherwise, you can assign one player upstairs to solve the puzzle by themselves, but it will take them a very long time to run between buttons and solve the puzzle, and they'll be dodging the droids that show up. Close range players downstairs will not want to stand within the caution lines on the floor, as a puzzle solver may forget to give warning before they unleash the fire from the pipe, and anyone within those caution lines will get hit. In story mode, you'll take very little damage, but in veteran mode, standing in the caution lines will hurt. If you happen to be running 16-person veteran mode Karagga's Palace, there's an extra spicy step to solving the puzzle. When one of your team members clicks a piece of the puzzle, they will not be able to immediately click any of the puzzle terminals again until someone else clicks any of the puzzle terminals. If you have 3 players up top like you would an 8-person, this isn't a huge problem at first, as you're usually just transferring the puzzle pieces between columns, so the same person isn't clicking twice in a row anyway. However, if you're using the fastest method of solving, there will be a point where you need to click the same terminal twice in a row. The player on that terminal will not be able to click their terminal button again, so you can either have their buddy, who isn't next in the puzzle, clicking rotation over and click it for them, or your team can choose to have a 4th player, for example a healer, involved to help click that terminal when this happens, which will be the fastest option and allow your team to get the speed needed to avoid the droids. This mechanic is called biometric lockout, and it's a debuff, which means you cannot click the puzzle until another player clicks the puzzle before you. I hope you enjoyed this in-depth guide about Star Wars The Old Republic's Karagga's Palace Operation. This is part of a series of guides to cover the bosses and the operations. If you want to show your support for this series, please visit swtorista.com/support and make a pledge. And if you want similar Star Wars The Old Republic videos to show up on your YouTube homepage, subscribe to this channel. As always, may the Force be with you.